Yes.
Do we have to write our country's name if we have not been recognized, or like our name?
Your country's name. So Sudan is first, and except Sudan, has everyone else spoken?
I have not spoken. That is why I'm writing in the chat.
Okay. Sudan, Maldives, sorry, haven't you spoken in moderate caucus at all?
No, I've not.
Okay.
I raised a motion, but...
That's fine. So Sudan, followed by Maldives, followed by Egypt, followed by Italy, followed by Belgium. Who else? Divyanka, you're raising your hand.
Yes, Chair, point of parliamentary inquiry.
Yes. One second. Followed by Philippines. Yeah.
Yes, so will we continue with the solutions, or will we do another modcock after the GSL?
Right now, we'll go into GSL. After that, seeing how much time we have left, we can have one modcock for 10 or 15 minutes, and then we can jump into solutions. All right.
Okay,
so Delegate Sudan, you may now have the floor for 90 seconds.
Thank you, Honorable Chair. 50 years ago, United States President John F. Kennedy said, "Ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country." Today, ask not what the world can do for you, but what you can do for the world. So with this quote, I want to ask you a question. Do you think it is possible for us to live in a world without rapes? The people of my country think so. We believe we can achieve the end of rapes. Rape culture is a sociological theory of a setting in which rape is pervasive and normalized due to societal attitudes about gender and sexuality. Entire societies have been alleged to be rape cultures. The government of Sudan has taken a number of steps to combat violence against women. In 2005, a new unit was created in the Ministry of Justice that is in charge of implementing the plan. A number of measures were announced by the government of Sudan in 2007, stipulating a policy of zero tolerance against sexual violence and provision of medical care and increasing the number of women police officers. We proposed that victims of rape be provided with an effective remedy under Sudanese legislation. In addition, any barriers to effective access to justice for rape victims should be removed. We propose a comprehensive revision of the law on sexual violence that would bring Sudanese legislation in line with the Bill of Rights, international treaty obligations, and best practices from other countries. The reform of rape provision is important but would be incomplete because it would not capture a number of other forms of sexual violence which also need to be repressed.
Thank you, Delegate.
Thank you.
Followed by Maldives.
Am I audible?
Yes, Delegate, you're audible.
Okay. Greetings to one and all present here. I'm the Delegate of Maldives. Rape means sexual intercourse without any valid consent. It means that being sexually assaulted. If the person you're having sexual activities with you says no and you refuse to acknowledge what he said, that is called rape. The rape rate in Maldives in 2013 was 1.4 cases per 100,000 population. Though the Maldives rape rate has fluctuated substantially in the recent years, the punishment for rape is a maximum for 15 years of criminal imprisonment, and rape is punished by a maximum of 20 years in certain factors, including the victim's age is under 15 years. And the rape is punished a maximum of 30 years of criminal imprisonment where the victim is caused to death. The rape culture. What is rape culture? Rape culture is not being able to wear what the women and girls want. Rape culture is being told that after someone has sexual activities with you, no one would ever want you again. Rape culture is getting...
Thank you, Delegate. Delegate of Egypt, you may now have the floor for 90 seconds.
Thank you, Chair, for the recognition. Women across social media have been coming forward about their sexual assault cases and exposing their harassers. An Egyptian woman decided to finally speak out as well. But one thing that never changes and is often swept under the rug is how women are treated in Middle East countries, especially Egypt. But to be fair, awareness is being raised every day about women's rights and the importance of consent. More men are taking stands against harassers and are striving to protect women from any unwanted or uncomfortable situation. The younger generations are more aware of the issue and are calling for women's rights and laws. Education about women's health, privacy, and legal actions they can take is happening in areas of Egypt. Many stories are now being shared by girls who are able to find support from other women and men and when they are harassed and in the street. More people are standing against sexual abuse, but the problem still exists. It will take time and effort to minimize the problem. Laws have to be stricter, and police need to start applying the law on abusers and harassers to start the change. We hope that the first step against the harassers will be a good step into a more free, friendly, and safe environment for women everywhere in Egypt. Thank you.
Thank you, Delegate. You have 20 seconds remaining. Where would you like to yield your time?
To the chair.
Thank you, Delegate. Delegate of Italy, you may now have the floor for 90 seconds.
Thank you, Honorable Chair, for the organization. Rape culture is affecting women all over the world. Italy has a lower capita rate of rape than most of the advanced Western countries in the European Union, but still, Italian women are victims of sexual violence. The Italian legal framework to combat violence against women have evolved over time. In 1996, Italian Parliament enacted a new rape law. While the old law classified rape as a crime against the public morality, the new law declares it a crime against the person. In Italy, specialist services for women victims are provided mainly by anti-violence centers. These are centers run by non-governmental organizations which supports counseling, trauma care, legal counseling, empowerment, and support towards achieving economic independence, advocacy, and outreach services, telephone helplines, and specific services for children and victims. Within the media system, the National Public Broadcasting Service adopted specific guidelines for better and advocate for portraying women. Every year, on a designated Wednesday in April, women all over the world wear denim to recognize Denim Day. Denim Day, formally organized by the new non-profit Peace Over Violence, was started after the Italian Supreme Court ruled against a rape victim's case in 1999. To conclude, Italy's efforts to implement the Women, Peace and Security Resolution are also linked to the overall protection of women's and girls' human rights and equality. Thank you.
Thank you, Delegate. Before we move further, I would want to know, so there are 37, participants and 30 of us, I know there are 30 delegates, that's why I took attendance. Three of us are the EB members, one is IP, one is Amrita ma'am. Who else is there?
Point of personal privilege, can you repeat what you said as you weren't audible?
Am I audible now? Wait, let me update the meeting first. Yeah. I think we'll need to make another meeting because I don't know, this meeting ends in 9 minutes. But yeah, so I'll send the link right away. But what I'm asking is that we took attendance and there were only 30 delegates. There are three EB members, one IP member, and one teacher. So we are still, okay, so there's still one of them left. So there's still one participant. We do not know who it is.
There are two IP members.
There are two IP members?
Yes, two reporters. Three are supposed to be here, but two are present right now.
All right. For some reason, this meeting is ending. I'm sending another link. Please join there. And then we'll take it from there. Thank you.